has given you the power. God has enabled you. God has created you that you may dominate this earth.
Oh, yes.
And because his purpose is to make you above everything.
Uh-huh.
And these are the words that the Lord says in Jeremiah 1, that we create a person in our image.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody who has been created. And in Genesis 2 verse 7, he says about what? Let him give him power to dominate.
Yes.
Domination as you coming above anything.
Uh-huh.
Not looking at things that are putting you down.
Uh-huh.
If you know what is taking you down, you have to tell it now from today. I stand by the authority. I stand by the power and bring every stronghold down. Because that is the purpose of God.
Amen.
God never chose you from a village that your villages are never to conquer you.
Uh-huh.
You are not chosen in that village to be saved that the people can determine your life.
No.
You are supposed to determine the future.
You are talking. Mm-hmm.
So what we are seeing that when the Bible is saying the people that stood against Paul, they went against Paul because they did not want him to go and preach.
Yes.
These people stood because they wanted to be the king of the fathers.
Mm-hmm.
They did not want any other religion. They did not want anybody with any knowledge.
True.
And this is what is happening around.
Oh, yes, Lord.
So the question is, will you be the person that God has created or will you be the person to be used? Will you be the person that you're going to be ahead, or you be the tail? When everybody looks at you and say, Angalia.
Uh-uh.
Amen?
Amen?
Can you cause a tremor in your village?
Oh, yes.
Can you cause a tremor in your life?
I'm ready.
Amen?
Amen?
It does not matter what the people are talking about. The story about you is not what people know.
True.
Amen?
Amen.
Because that is not the foundation that the Lord God called you for. Remember in Jeremiah 1 verse 10, he has pruned you, he has set you aside, he has put his works in you, that you
me.
May be used
mm-hmm.
to destroy the foundations of the devil.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen?
Amen.
So anything about which you know about you, people saying you cannot speak, people saying you are a tremor, people saying you are a kid, those are people.
Mm-hmm.
God does not look at the things that you see. God is not after your mind, your understanding. Because your knowledge will take you nowhere.
True.
But you have to ask yourself, what is your plan?
Mm-hmm.
And you know when you read the book of Psalms, the Bible says, why is God after you? Why is God looking at you? What is the expectation that God has to talk about you?
Mm-hmm.
Psalms 8, verse 4. What is man that you take notice of him?
Uh-huh.
Or the son of man that you pay attention to him.
Uh-huh.
You made him a little less than divine, but you crowned him with glory and honor. Amen?
Amen.
So, look at yourself. God is concerned about you. And the one is saying, who are you? Why should God not be concerned about me? Why should God be concerned about my future? Why should God be concerned that I, Tom, I, whatever you are, he can use you to break these foundations.
Amen.
And you know, when the writer is talking about, he's saying, you have been created. Listen, let's go to the creation, Genesis 1, verse 26.
Uh-huh.
When God is saying he created man in his own likeness and gave him the power in Genesis 2. Amen?
Amen.
He gave him to be power to control everything in air, on earth, and air in the waters.
Oh, yes.
Amen?
Amen.
And one thing I was looking at, that when God was creating you, he never said, let it be a man, but you are molded first.
Mm-hmm.
In Genesis 2, he says he molded the earth. And when he molded you, he raised it to you.
Mm-hmm.
And when the man of God is talking about the body and the spirit, you realize that the body was made from man.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
And when he breathed to him, he gave it a soul.
Yes.
And the soul gave the spirit of God. So a human being was formed.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen.
Formed for what purpose?
What purpose?
And this purpose is what he said. We look at the story of Adam. God tells Adam, you will name everything. Dominate.
Dominate.
Have authority upon everything.
Oh, yes.
Amen?
Amen.
And when you look at even the story of Noah, when Noah is calling the animals, they were called by names and they walked by names. Names that were given by Adam.
Oh, yes.
Amen?
Amen.
And we learned that whatever our ancestors did, whatever our fathers did, when they disobeyed God, when they disobeyed God, they fell into sin. And they were bound by sin. and they have slept in sin and have not accepted to come out of sin. And that's what we are learning, that the bondages following you have been done because of sacrifices.
Oh, yes.
Because of people not realizing what God has put for them and doing things that are